Starship Test Flight 1 was an amazing success, and the SpaceX team did a great job, and there was a tremendous amount of valuable information learned. The company hopes to launch another Starship rocket as soon as July or August, but the timeline depends on a variety of factors, including repair work, regulatory sign-off and the readiness of its next prototype. The highest hurdle to a second launch attempt may be the launch mount. Soon after the launch, SpaceX began the process of upgrading up the launchpad and assessing the damage to its infrastructure. The space agency has a vested interest in the success of Starship, as NASA gave SpaceX a nearly $3 billion contract in 2021 to use the rocket to land astronauts on the moon as part of the Artemis program. The focus of today's conversation is on the recent massive renovations to SpaceX's Starbase launch pad, which were completed only last week. Musk, SpaceX's enigmatic CEO, set a one-month deadline for the completion of these important modifications via a tweet, indicating that the SpaceX team is gearing up for significant advances. The installation work that is being done is significant and revolutionary. The current state of the groundwork reveals a sprawling web of holes drilled into the earth, each containing a rebar cage that was later filled with concrete. The visible busy ground drill is positioned over creeping softer ground, drilling holes that quickly fill with water due to the shallow water table. Furthermore, sheet pilings are being installed around the perimeter of the orbital launch mount, which will produce a solid retaining wall that can be dug for installing pipe work and steel water-cooled plates. Based on these extraordinary advances, SpaceX appears to be on schedule to make its deadline. Some may wonder why an innovative firm, capable of handling challenging challenges in the space sector, such as SpaceX, suffered such substantial damage to its launch pad. However, it is critical to understand that this was not the consequence of just another rocket launch. The Starship, the most powerful rocket ever built, was responsible for the devastation. The scale of this launch was astounding. When fully loaded, the Starship's 33 first-stage Raptor engines produced an estimated 16.5 million pounds of thrust. So that you can understand this when comparing the results of each flight. The NASA Space Launch System, or SLS Mega Rocket, which previously held the record for the most powerful rocket to fly successfully, produced 8.8 million pounds of thrust. However, the SLS launch did cause some damage to Pad 39B. The aftermath of the Starship's debut was significantly more severe, resulting in a crater beneath the orbital launch mount and massive devastation from flying debris. However, considering the Starship's remarkable strength, the degree of devastation was not entirely foreseeable. In light of these unique conditions, we might likely not regard this occurrence as a failure, but rather as a fantastic showcase of what these new super strong rockets are capable of. Even the fact that the launch pad withstood this huge force to such a degree is an engineering triumph. The orbital launch of the Starbase is unique. The mount lacks a flame trench, which is a common structure in most launch pads, meant to redirect plume exhaust away from the pad during liftoff. SpaceX considered installing a flame trench at Starbase but opted against it. Musk even acknowledged his desire to not have a flame diverter in Boca back in October 2020, noting that this could be a mistake. Despite the damage, SpaceX and Musk continue to see a future for Starbase that does not include a flame trench. Musk disclosed on Twitter that SpaceX has begun constructing a large water-cooled steel plate to put beneath the launch mount. Although the plate was not ready in time for the first Starship launch 3 months ago, the corporation proceeded with the belief that the underlying concrete, a particular heat-resistant variety known as fondag, could endure one liftoff. Despite the spectacular finale of the April 20th launch, this assessment was based on data from the Starship's first full-force static fire in February. SpaceX is substantially investing in the Starship project. By the end of this year, SpaceX expects to have spent $5 billion or more on the Starship vehicle and launch infrastructure. Since 2014, SpaceX has committed more than $3 billion in the Boca Chica launch pad and the Starship Super Heavy launch system. However, SpaceX is currently seeking to intervene in a lawsuit filed against the Federal Aviation Administration, or FAA, by several environmental and Native American groups. The suit alleges that the FAA conducted an improper environmental review of SpaceX Starship launches from Boca Chica, Texas. The lawsuit's goal is to have the FAA revoke the existing launch license for Starship Super Heavy Orbital launches from Boca Chica. If the plaintiff is successful, the FAA will be found to have violated environmental law and regulations during the licensing procedure. As the corporation stated in its submission, if the FAA's judgment is overturned, future licensing of the Starship Super Heavy program could be greatly delayed, causing serious harm to SpaceX's company throughout its history. SpaceX has faced various legal problems, many of which have involved the FAA. The FAA has previously punished SpaceX for infractions linked to its launches, including times where the firm continued with launches, despite the FAA's warnings owing to safety concerns. These incidences have caused conflict between the two institutions. However, the relationship between SpaceX and the FAA appears to have evolved over time, reflecting a deeper understanding of SpaceX's operational approach ambition. The FAA's decision to issue a launch license for Starship, from Boca Chica, represents a shift in its perspective towards the company. This does not mean that the FAA has eased on its regulations, but it does indicate that the agency recognizes the revolutionary potential that the Starship represents and is willing to work with the company. The Starship is envisioned to be a fully reusable spacecraft, capable of carrying up to 100 people to the red planet Mars. These advancements aren't just about reaching Mars. The broader vision is to fundamentally change the way we approach space travel. Rather than the single-use vehicles of the past, SpaceX is developing spacecraft that function more like traditional airliners, able to complete multiple journeys rather than just one. As for the next launch license, SpaceX should be in the clear from Boca Chica. Since the 2022 programmatic environmental assessment, SpaceX has provided the FAA with additional information regarding the Starship's planned soft water landing and the launchpad detonation suppression system. The FAA has published a written reevaluation that evaluates whether supplemental environmental analysis is required to support the FAA Office of Commercial Space Transportation decision to issue a vehicle operator license based on this new information. The FAA concluded in the written reevaluation that the issuance of a vehicle operator license for Starship Super Heavy operation, the prior environmental documentation, that the data collected in the late 2022 programmatic environmental assessment remained substantially valid. There are no significant environmental changes, and that all conditions and requirements of the prior approval have been met, or will be met in the current action, and that the preparation is complete. It even set up a hotline promoted by the county for local residents to report debris. Some think the company will move quickly to launch Starship again. SpaceX moves fast when they see what needs to be fixed, Abhi Tripathi, a former SpaceX mission director, wrote on Twitter. Quote, I assume they will address the launch site findings with the same importance they show to the Starship design issues. Got to think of it in terms of a whole system. SpaceX is also building a launch tower for Starship at one of its pads at the Kennedy Space Center in Florida, potentially giving it an alternative launch site. In granting SpaceX preliminary approval last year, the FAA required the company to meet 75 requirements intended to protect the environment. But some environmental groups have said they don't go far enough and that the rockets endanger native wildlife and the fragile ecosystem. From our point of view, it's good news it didn't blow up at the pad site, but future launches could, American Bird Conservancy President Michael Parr told The Washington Post after the launch. Had an explosion taken place over the sensitive wetlands, a cleanup would further disturb the environment, he said.